Today is Thursday, April 1st. For the Christian, it is also known as Maundy Thursday. Hello, my name is Perrin Prescott, and this is the fourth installment of the Holy Week Encouragements from Hampton Falls First Baptist Church. On Monday, Pastor Grant shared the Passover meal, a Jewish celebration commemorating freedom from the bondage of Egypt. Tuesday, Pastor Ken referenced John 1:29. Look, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. And yesterday, Mark Stubbs shared the unleavened bread and how we view this as Jesus' broken body for us. Today is Maundy Thursday. This is the Christian holy day that falls on the Thursday before Easter. It is also the day where Jesus washes the feet of his disciples and they participated in the Last Supper, the Passover meal. We see this event as the observance of communion, the bread, Jesus' body, and his shed blood, the cup. During the Passover meal, there are actually four cups that are shared with those who participate. The New Testament account in the Gospels speaks of only the one cup, but this was the Passover meal, and we can be pretty sure that everyone participated in this memorial feast, and they drank from all four cups. Each cup references one of God's I will statements from Exodus 6:6. I will bring you out from under the yoke of the Egyptians. I will free you from being slaves to them. I will redeem you with an outstretched arm and with mighty acts of judgment. And I will take you as my own people, and I will be your God. The first cup is the cup of sanctification. To be set apart, to be holy. God called the nation of Israel out of Egypt to be set apart. The Old Testament is clear. They refused to be separate. Through Christ, we, who are followers of Christ, are now the ones God has called to be his own. Sanctification is that process of becoming like Christ. John MacArthur explained it well. It's like standing in a railroad track looking down. It looks like the rails off in the distance actually join. Walking towards them, we realize that they never do, but it is a journey the Christian must take. We have been called to be set apart. 1 Peter 2:9 says, "But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light." The second cup is the cup of deliverance. Before the nation of Israel left captivity, God had sent 10 judgments on Egypt. This cup was tasted during the meal of Passover as a reminder that God is the judge of all and his judgment on man will be coming. This cup for the Christian is oh so wonderful. Because of Christ, the Messiah, we may escape the penalty of judgment because Jesus shed his blood for our redemption. Again, in 1 Peter chapter 9, he himself bore our sins in his body on the cross so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed. The third cup is the one that we actually take in when we observe and participate in communion. It is recorded in Matthew 26. Jesus took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." This cup is the cup of redemption. During the Passover meal, it also was tasted to reflect what praise to God for redeeming the nation of Israel from the bonds of Egypt. For the Christian, it is our eternal redemption done once and for all through the blood of Christ. We now have a new covenant, one that is perfect in every way, and through Jesus we now have the perfect law. Hebrews 9 and 14 says, "How much more then will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleansed our consciences from acts that lead to death, For this reason, Christ is the mediator of a new covenant, that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance. He has died as a ransom to set them free from the sins committed under the first covenant. Diane Sherlaw Ferreira wrote about this third cup. It was his blood that was shed on the cross as a final atonement, as a payment for sins. His arms outstretched on a tree, he gave himself up for us to pay the price that was ours to pay. The one who knew no sin became sin for us, and he paid our debt. He took the curse on himself in our place. To end is to go where we began, Exodus 6:6. I will take you as my own people, and I will be your God. Then you will know that I am the Lord your God who brought you out from under the yoke of the Egyptians. The final cup is the cup of praise. This Passover cup has the Jewish people look forward towards their acceptance into the kingdom of the Father. They are still looking. Yet for you and for me, the benefactors of God's mercy through Christ, we look forward to the hope that is in our acceptance through Christ and how he is our hope and praise to the glory of God. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the older order of things has passed away." Passover for the nation of Israel is a time to contemplate God's plan for mankind. Easter for the nation of Christians is a time to celebrate God's plan, fulfilled through the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world.